Good morning, my dear students. Today we start a new unit, which is current electricity. And in this unit, new chapter, which is electric current. Okay. So we start electric current. First, definition of electric current. Okay. In small classes, we have studied electric current. So, what is electric current? The rate of flow of charge, in the conductor is called electric current. This is very simple. Suppose we have a conductor. This is a conductor. Then, in this conductor, the rate of flow of charge. Charge means electron charge. In this conductor is called electric current. Okay, we can say that the amount of charge, the total amount of charge that flow through the cross-sectional area, this cross-sectional area in per unit time is called electric current. Again, the total amount of charge that flows through the cross-sectional area in per unit time is called electric current. Electric current is represented by I sign. Suppose the amount of a charge Q that flows through the cross-sectional area A in per unit time, means in time T, then electric current I is equals to Q upon T. This is the formula of electric current. According to this formula, we can say the rate of flow of charge in any conductor is called electric current. Okay. Unit. Unit of electric current is, according to this formula, this is coulomb upon second. But electric current is a fundamental quantity. So, unit of electric current is ampere, and it is represented by capital A. So, unit of electric current is ampere. Okay. If a del Q charge, flow from cross-sectional area, this A cross-sectional area in del T time interval, then average current, average electric current, I average equals to, we can write del Q upon a del. Okay. And for a instant time T, instantaneous current I is equals to, here instant time T, it means time is very small, then limit tends, del T tends to zero. This time interval is very small, then this electric current is called instantaneous electric current. I is equals to limit del T tends to zero del Q upon del T, and it represented by dQ upon dt. This is electric current. Okay. And unit of electric current is ampere. Now, direction of electric current. Direction of electric current is in the direction of a flow of positive charge, means positive ions, and opposite to the flow of electron. It means we can say the direction of a electric current is in the circuit, is opposite to the flow of a electron. It means if a direction of flow of electron is in this direction, then current of direction is opposite to the flow of electrons. Okay. But current is a scalar quantity. The current has a direction which is opposite to the flow of electron, but it is still a scalar quantity, because of a electric current does not obey the law of a vector addition. In 11th class, we study a law of vector addition, which is resultant vector is equals to the sum of vector sum of a to another vector quantity. दिस इज रिजल्टेंट वेक्टर, ओके, एंड दिस इलेक्ट्रिक करंट डज नॉट ऑबे द लॉज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक एडिशन, ओके, सो इट इज ए स्केलर क्वांटिटी. नाउ डेफिनेशन ऑफ 1 एम्पियर फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला, इफ q इज इक्वल्स टू 1 कूलम एंड t इज इक्वल्स टू 1 सेकेंड, t इज इक्वल्स टू 1 सेकेंड, देन I इज इक्वल्स टू 1 एम्पियर, I इज इक्वल्स टू 1 एम्पियर. सो फ्रॉम दिस कंडीशन वी कैन से वेन 1 कूलम चार्ज इन फ्लोइंग इन ए कंडक्टर इन 1 सेकेंड, देन फ्लोइंग करंट इन कंडक्टर इज 1 एम्पियर. ओके, अगेन वेन 1 कूलम चार्ज इज फ्लोइंग इन ए कंडक्टर इन 1 सेकेंड इन यूनिट सेकेंड, देन फ्लोइंग करंट इज कंडक्टर इन कंडक्टर इज इक्वल टू 1 एम्पियर. दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ए 1 एम्पियर. ओके, सो वी कैन से करंट फ्लोइंग इन कंडक्टर, करंट फ्लोइंग इन कंडक्टर ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू ए सेमीकंडक्टर, सेमीकंडक्टर, सेमीकंडक्टर वी विल डिस्कस इन आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर्स. सेमीकंडक्टर ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड होल्स, होल इज द एब्सेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो इन सेमीकंडक्टर इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लोइंग ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड होल्स, बट इन कंडक्टर दिस इज ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, नाउ आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज करंट डेंसिटी, करंट डेंसिटी. This is a type of density, simple density. Simple density is the amount of mass in per unit volume. Similarly, current density is the amount of current flowing through the unit cross-sectional area. Okay, so we can say the current flowing through the unit cross-sectional area of a conductor is called current density. It is represented by Z. So according to definition we can write J is equals to I upon A. If A is equals to 1 meter square, then J is equals to I. So we define current density as the current flowing through the unit cross-sectional area of a conductor is called current density. Okay, unit of current density, we know that unit of a electric current is ampere and unit of a area is meter square. Yeah, here we take area is by small capital S. So unit of current density is ampere upon meter square. Okay, this is a vector quantity and direction of a current density is in the direction of current. Suppose direction of current is this, then direction of a current density is the same direction of a electric current. Okay, now if we del I current flow perpendicular surface area, suppose this is the direction of a current and a surface area which is kept in this electric current perpendicular to direction of a current, then suppose a small element del S and a current flowing to this small element is del I, then current density J is equals to del I upon del S. Okay, at any instant t current density J is equals to limit del S tends to zero. It means surface area is very small and del I upon del S, and it is represented like as di upon ds. This is the current density at any time t. Okay, now another condition we take, if an area del s is not perpendicular to current, it means like this, this is direction of current and this is area, it is represented by del s, it is not perpendicular to current, then direction of this area is del s, make an angle theta from the direction of current, but normal to the area makes an angle theta with the direction of current, then in this condition current density, in this condition current density j is equals to del I upon del s cos theta. Del s cos theta is the component along to the direction of current. So here del I is equals to j into del s cos of theta. Theta is the angle between a direction of current density, because of a direction of current density is in the direction of electric current. So theta is the angle between direction of current density and direction of a surface. Direction of a surface area, then we can write del I is equals to j vector dot del s vector. Okay, if area is finite, if we take a finite area, then I is equals to integration j vector dot ds vector. Okay, this is the current density for a finite area. Okay, now our next topic is flow of charge. Next topic is flow of electric charge in metallic conductors. Okay, suppose we know that in a conductor the free electrons are present and they move randomly like this. This is a conductor and a free electron moves like the motion of this electron is zigzag motion. Okay, in this situation average velocity, in this situation average velocity of this free electron is zero, means v average is equals to zero. Okay, because this electron moves in all possible direction of velocities. Okay, but when we potential difference applied on this conductor, suppose this is a conductor and we apply a potential difference at the end of this conductor V, then in this situation a electric field is produced between the plates. Suppose this is charged by positive and this is negative, then a electric field is produced. Due to this, electric current is flowing in this conductor, because some values, we find some values of a average velocity. Okay, this is the flow of electric charge in metallic conductors. In this sequence we study next topic, drift velocity. Drift velocity, this is very important definition for our annual examination. Drift velocity, what is drift velocity? In this sequence, next we study, we can say in absence of electric field, in absence of electric field, electrons move randomly. But when we apply a potential difference at the end of conductor, then an electric field is produced in this conductor. And due to this electric field, the force, we know that according to chapter 1, if a charge is placed in a uniform electric field, then a force act on this charge. Due to this, we can say in this electric field, the force on the free electrons, the force on the free electrons is in the opposite direction to the electric field, because electron is attracted by positive charge. So the force, direction of force is opposite to the electric field, and due to this force, acceleration in these free electrons is generated. Okay, so we get average velocity, some average velocity of these free electrons. Okay, due to this, we can say in the presence of electric field, definition of, we say definition of drift velocity, in the presence of electric field, the average value of velocity of free electron, again, in the presence of electric field, the average value of velocity of free electrons in a conductor is called drift velocity, and drift velocity is represented by Vd vector. Okay, now in this zigzag motion, this electron collide with another electron, and we can say the path between two consecutive collisions, this is one collision, this is another collision, okay? The path between two consecutive collisions in this conductor, which is traveled by this free electron, which is traveled by this free electron, is called free path. So what is free path? Free path, which direction which is traveled by this free electron and this between the two consecutive collisions, this is represented by lambda. Okay, and the mean, means the average of such type of paths, is called mean free path. Mean free path, and it is represented by lambda bar. Okay, so what is free path? The path between two consecutive collisions in a conductor which is traveled by free electrons is called free path, and average of all such type of paths is called mean free path. Okay, and this electron sometime taken, this electron sometime taken between two consecutive collisions. Okay, so we can say the time taken by free electron, the time taken by free electron in between two collisions, any two collisions like this, two collisions between, like between two collisions, is called relaxation time. Relaxation time, and it is represented by tau, and mean relaxation time is represented by tau bar. This is mean relaxation time. Okay, now we determine a formula of drift velocity. For this, suppose we have small n free electrons in a conductor, and their initial, it is random velocities are suppose u1, u2, u3, and so on un. Okay, and relaxation times tau1, tau2, tau3, and so on, tau n for n electrons respectively, then according to definition of drift velocity, drift velocity is equals to the average of all velocities of electrons. From previous class, we know most equation of motion, v is equals to u plus a t. Here v is the velocity, u is the initial velocity, a acceleration, and time t taken in this velocity. Okay, so due to this equation, we can write velocities for all electrons. So first electron u1 plus a vector tau1. Okay, for second u2 plus a vector tau2. Here acceleration is the same for all electrons, because The force act on all electrons is the same. So for n electrons, un plus a vector 2n. And mean of these velocities by dividing n. So drift velocity Vd is equals to this equation. Now we separate different terms u1, u2, u3 and so on un upon n. And in second term, a vector is the common. So a vector tau1 plus tau2 plus tau3 and so on tau n upon n. This equation represents the average random velocity, or we can say initial average of initial velocities. And we know that mean of random velocity of free electrons is zero. So this quantity is equal to zero, and this term is represented in the mean relaxation time tau bar. This is mean relaxation time tau bar. Tau bar is equals to the average of all relaxation times. Okay, so Vd vector is equals to, this term is equals to zero, a vector tau bar. What is a vector? A vector is the acceleration of free electron, and in the presence of electric field, a vector, we know that F is equals to ma. So A is equals to F upon M. Here F is the force act on electron and M is the mass of electron. And we know that force on the electron in the presence of electric field, which is equal to minus EE vector. Here negative sign indicates that the direction of force is opposite to the direction of electric field. So A vector is equals to minus EE vector upon M. Put the value of acceleration in this equation, then we get drift velocity Vd vector is equals to minus EE vector upon m into tau bar. This is the value of drift velocity. Okay, this topic is very important for our annual examination. So you should learn this definition and this formula. This is the drift velocity Vd is equals to minus E vector upon m tau bar. Here Vd drift velocity, negative sign indicate the direction of drift velocity is opposite to the direction of electric field. E is the charge of a electron, this is external electric field, and this is mass of electron, and this is mean relaxation time. Okay students, thank you.